My last advice to you as students is this, that you must know that all teachers who ever become teachers, they joined that profession because somewhere they were idealists. Teaching is a very hard job. It's not an easy job. You have to bring the same passion in every class. The same lesson plan has to be taught again and again and again, year after year. And in each time, the teacher has to find that passion, that energy, that individual treatment that they have to give to each and every student. And in these times when they are overloaded with work, they are under a lot of pressure to give results, there is an administration overload that they have, sometimes that idealism gets covered with the daily routine of just trying to stay alive and survive and just do that 8-hour shift day after day after day. And sometimes it's the job of students to keep reminding the teachers that it is truly an ideal, it's an idealistic profession, because we just had a young lad explain how even by touching 10 lives, you actually touched 1500 lives. You can imagine what teachers do throughout their career. They actually make a lot of people achieve their potential, which otherwise they wouldn't have. And I can give you some examples of this, which I hopefully will be able to tell you one of two stories which will tell you that. For teachers, I have a couple of things that I wanted to share. I myself was an instructor in the army. My job was to train young officers who would then lead their own troops into battle. And it was a tough job because unlike the private sector or the corporates or any other profession, we don't have the luxury in our game that if we make a mistake this quarter, we'll make up in the next quarter. It doesn't work like that. If we lose market share, we don't have the ability to make it in the next quarter. If we make a widow this quarter, she'll remain a widow for the rest of her life. If we make an orphan this quarter, that kid will remain an orphan for the rest of their life. So as an instructor, I had to be a little harsh because we had to train our young officers to hold the lives of more than 100 souls in their hand. And I want to go back to my own days as a student in the academy. So when I passed out of the Indian Military Academy, I was 313th in merit out of a course of 400. So that takes a lot of hard work to come 313. We are the ones who made the remaining 75% possible. So after my joining the unit, in the army we are sent for courses. And our first foundation course is called the Young Officers Course. That's the first foundation course where, you know, your career is kind of decided after that. How you perform in that course kind of determines which path your career will take. Now, for an officer who has been 313th in merit, even the commanding officer, even my boss, didn't have that much of expectation. And in the army, we have a grading system which is Alpha, Bravo, and Charlie. Any army brats here will be able to tell you that. Alpha is 75% and above, Bravo is about 60% and above, anyone who is below 60% is considered to be Charlie. So in a course you'll normally have about, in a course of 100 you'll have maybe about 4 or 5 Alphas, you'll have about 20-30 Bravos and maybe about 40 to 50 Charlies. That's the way the course is sort of pans out. So when I was going for the course also, my CO told me, try to get a Bravo, kam se kam Bravo le lena, don't come in buddy Charlie. That was the expectation that he had. And I had also decided that in life, okay, I'll try to be a Bravo so that I'm in the middle. If you're in the front, you have to do a lot of hard work. If you're in the back, you will get kicked a lot. So, you know, somewhere in the beach, mein ghode ko chalate raho, jang ke maidan mein. So you'll be fine. That was my sort of understanding. And so I'd set up my routine. I used to study for the first lecture in the class, one or two topics, and be the first one to answer a question so that the, you know, instructor has registered me. Ah, okay, this chap has answered. And then go off to sleep throughout the class. In the evening, do the bare minimum effort required to get to the next day. And that was my life during that course. And then I had an instructor called Sandeep Bajaj. He's a very senior officer now, but that time he was just a lieutenant. One day he just walked into my room and he saw that I was getting ready to do my favorite evening pastime, which was going to the bar. So he asked me, where are you going? So I said, sir, I'm going to the library, you know, to study and all. So he said, you're going to the bar, aren't you? I said, well, sir. He said, why don't you do one thing? My sense is you are heading for an alpha. You have the potential to get an alpha. Why don't you just give it a shot tonight, because tomorrow is a midterm exam. just work on it tonight, and if it doesn't work out, you can always go back and make up, you know, day after tomorrow for all your quota, you can make it up. I don't know whether he was telling me the truth or not. I still don't know till date. But that night, that one person telling me, you know, I said, what the heck, let me just try to do it. And I put in maybe 2-3 hours of effort in that night. And the next day I performed well. I went on to become not only an alpha in that course, but I got an instructor grading in that course. And from that day, my life changed completely. Because within 2 or 3 courses, I had started topping the courses. And by the 5th or the 6th course, if my name would be there on the list, people would now argue who will get the second prize because the first one is gone. Now this didn't happen magically overnight because I was quite happy to be a mediocre student. I was quite happy to get a Bravo and come back. That was my aspirational level. And if I had got a Bravo and come back, I would have thought, I'm okay, I've done well. But for this one person who came and found that spark, and I think that's what great teachers are supposed to do. Great teachers are supposed to treat every child in the class as if it is their own child. If it is your own child, you're not going to give up, even if the child is a Bravo, you're not going to give up if the child is a Charlie. And I think the true hallmark of an instructor, which by the way in the armed forces is not given to anyone and everyone, you have to earn that badge that you wear on your shoulder. And truly great instructors seek the weak students. Because it is only then that their capability comes out. If you take a 95 percentile child and make him 98, your value add is 3%. But if you take someone on whom the entire society has given up and said he's a Charlie or she's a Charlie, and make that person come into an alpha, then you have earned this badge of an instructor. Then you can truly say that I am an acharya. Otherwise, to my mind, this value add of 2 to 3% on somebody who's already performing very well does not qualify a person to call themselves a true teacher.